Hi guys, co-tutor here, and my name is Anjudeshwan. In this particular video, I'll be talking about the lifecycle of an activity. In Android, activity is used to present the UI of the application. And if you do a little bit of Google search about the activity lifecycle, this is the diagram that you will come across. What I will be trying to do is show the lifecycle of the activity in a little bit more practical manner, that is actually through coding. So without much ado, let me get started with the coding. I already have a activity here, and this particular activity has got a edit text view. It contains simple onCreate method. As some of you might be aware, this is the very first method that gets executed when you start an activity. Other than the onCreate method, you have few more other methods. Those methods are onStart, onResume, and after that you have other three more methods, that is onPause, onStop, and onDestroy. So these are considered to be the main lifecycle methods of an activity. So let us try to understand in which particular sequence these things get executed. To do that, let me create a tag which is of type string, and I will be using it to basically log the output into the Logcat of the Android Studio. To do that, you basically have to do log.i, which basically stands for information. The first is tag, string type, and the second one is the message that you want to output in the Logcat. So let me write something like in method onCreate. So what we will do is we'll just replicate this across various methods. Now let us run this particular application. As you can see, when the activity got started, the methods that we are going to see here is onCreate, onStart, and onResume. When I hit the back button, the methods that I am going to see is onPause, onStop, and onDestroy. If I now restart the application once again, you will once again see that onCreate, onStart, and onResume are getting executed. And if I hit the home button, you will observe that it will only go up to onStop. It will not execute the onDestroy. To actually execute the onDestroy method, you have to hit the back button. So you have to understand the fact that onCreate and onDestroy only get executed once throughout the lifecycle of an activity. Now if I hit the back button, you can see that activity is going to the background and it goes till towards onDestroy. Other than these six methods, you have another method which is called as onRestart. It gets executed whenever you restart an activity. So let us implement this method and see how it works. Let us rerun this and see. There is no difference. You still have onCreate, onStart, and onResume, and I hit the back button. Activity goes to the background, and since I have hit the back button, it goes till onDestroy. So no difference. I will once again restart the activity. It comes to till onResume. And now I hit the home button, which is not like destroying the activity. You will still see onPause and onStop. Now if I hit the activity to restart it, onRestart, onStart, and onResume. So onRestart always gets executed only when you have made the activity go in the background by hitting the home button, or if another activity comes on top of my activity. OnRestart gets executed when the activity comes back to the foreground from the background. I will be placing the code in the GitHub. You can download and try to understand how this particular application works. You can just tell me what are all new things that you would like to learn. I will try to include it in the new upcoming videos. Subscribe to the channel, give the feedback in the comment section. Take care. Bye.